Hey guys, what's up? So, I'm bringing you a brand new video game review. I actually have a subscriber who actually really enjoys these, so it's a good thing I'm doing another one because I haven't done one in a while. So, the video game I'm going to be reviewing is Doki Doki Literature Club. And I know a lot of the games that I've reviewed so far have been anime related. Yeah, I got a bit of a problem. I got a anime game addiction. How I developed it? Ask my old friend group. Because they caused it. But anyway, I digress. So, Doki Doki. Went into this game blind, as I do with every anime game that I go into when I try it out. And this one, really like it. I really enjoy it. It's really good. So, I pulled up files for the game. Make sure I get everybody's names right. And we have four characters that are very important to the story. You have Monica, who's the girl on the front here. You have Natsuki, Sayori, and Yuri. Yuri is a bookworm. She loves to read. But she's also a cutter, and she cuts herself. And so this is a very dark game. You know, on the cover and on the back, it looks like a very innocent anime game. But this game, let me tell you, it changed me for sure. I look at life a little differently now, and this game left some scars. So it's a number one psychological horror game. As it says on the back here, it's ranked number one. It's psychological horror, and it's the number one psychological horror experience. So basically, there's jump scares, there's glitches, there's times where you have to delete your data from the game, and you're not really deleting data, it's just part of the game. Sometimes you have to delete files, sometimes you have to restore the entire computer system, because this game takes place on like a computer setup. Actually, I have it pulled up here, so if you can see that, it looks like you're on a computer desktop, and you know, you got character files, game data, reset, and then if you go back, you can set wallpapers. I got mine as Monica. And you got files, side stories. I only have two of them unlocked right now. DDLC. That's to go into the main game. And I also have the TV muted, so that way I don't get a copyright claim for the music and the soundtrack. You got mail, pictures. Go to pictures, so you can change wallpapers. You have photos of different poems that each of the characters have written. And they all are about the main character, which you play as. You can name the character whatever you want. Here's some cutscenes from the game. Or images of cutscenes from the game. some poems. I didn't unlock all of them. Some images of just the different places that you go to. Most of the time you're hanging around in the school, but you do go to the other girls' houses at times. Then there's like different, you know, sketches of each of the characters, some sketch art, and then some seasonal holiday art, which is pretty cool actually. So that's some of that stuff. Music. So here's the soundtrack. And I was actually listening to that earlier. It's a pretty solid soundtrack. There's only one song on there that's like an actual song. The rest is just instrumental. Settings, files, side stories, and then going into the main game. So that's what that looks like. And I had my wallpaper set as Yuri when I played the game, but I switched it to Monica because my favorite color is green. So that's the main reason why I switched the desktop, or the desktop wallpaper, for the game. Now, this game does come with 6 new side stories, 13 additional music tracks, which, you know, when we looked at the soundtrack earlier, it's a pretty long soundtrack, 15 tracks. It's kind of disappointing that 90% of the soundtrack is instrumental and there's only one song, and it's the theme song to the game, which is the song that Monica writes for you at the end of the game if you take the Monica route. I apologize if I give away spoilers, but that's the only song on the soundtrack. So it says also, you know, on the back of here, like, packed with exclusive new content, which is all the stuff that I mentioned earlier right here. Rated M for violence, blood, suggestive themes, and strong language. To be quite honest, there's not as much blood as I anticipated with this game. Then again, it is, you know, an anime game. They can't really go super far, but then again, like, I mean, it is rated M, so I guess they could. I don't know. Strong language. I mean, there's very little strong language. Honestly, I didn't really see a whole lot, so that's a little misleading, but, you know, whatever. Violence. I mean, if you want to count jump scares as violence, I mean, this game's not really all that violent. I honestly see this game as more of like a rated T for teens. You know, because, but for whatever reason, they decided to make it rated M. Because really, the whole idea of this game is writing poems for each of the characters, and pretty much trying to get them to fall in love with you. And it's a lot like Galgun. If you've ever played Galgun, it's a lot like that. Where the main character that you play as has to find his true love, or fall in love, or whatever. Now, with Galgun, you have to find your true love within a day. In this game, you have to try and make one of the girls fall madly in love with you through writing poetry and being super deep and sentimental and, you know, all that type of shit. And it's a very, you know, high school drama-esque, but then again, you know, this game does take place in a high school, so so it's very very interesting to say the least. Also, for a game that's supposed to be, you know, psychological horror, I think the reason why they put it in that category is because this game can get very intense. There are some very unsettling moments throughout the entirety of the game where the screen will become fuzzy with TV static, and the screen will dim, and sometimes with each of the characters there will be big black bold text where the girls will end up saying some really, really crazy shit. And with Yuri's the biggest case of this, because she ends up falling so madly in love with you that she's willing to die. So she's a little bit off the edge, off her rocker. But, it's kind of part of her charm. I can't believe I just said that, but that's what I thought, you know, when I played this game the first time through. Monica gives off the wrong impression. I think that's the best way I can put it. She gives off the wrong impression at first. She's like the popular girl of the school, so she thinks she's all that. But you know what? I'll give credit where credit is due. Monica writes some really nice poems in this game. She really does. And so does Yuri. Really, all the girls write really good poems. But I think if I had to pick, you know, a top two, it would be Yuri and Monica. But if I had to pick just one, that's where it gets kind of tough for me, because it would either be Yuri or Monica. And this is where I'm going to spoil things a little bit, so I apologize. But it turns out Monica is the one who truly is in love with you. Like, she wants to be with you forever, and she, you know, means it. Even if it means, you know, all her friends die in the process, and there were two scenes that really, I don't want to say got under my skin, but really did hit me really hard, and that was when Yuri stabbed herself to death and bled out, and when Sayori hung herself in her bedroom. And that scene and that incident comes, like, damn near at the beginning of the game. Like, it's so, like, you get there real quick, and it's just like, oh, shit. Like, okay, here we go. Things are starting to take a darker turn, and a turn for the worse. So this is definitely not a game for the faint of heart. This is definitely not a game just to play. And, you know, video games are supposed to be fun and challenging, you know, some of them, and games are supposed to be, you know, an escape from reality and that kind of thing. But this is a game, you know, Doki Doki, this is a game where you gotta be tough. I actually can't believe I'm saying that about a game, especially a game that's anime, but you gotta have really, really thick skin to play this game. And actually, there's a warning when you first load up the game where it actually says this game is not suitable for people who are easily disturbed or who have depression. It also says this game is not suitable for children or for those who are easily disturbed and other things like that. So if you're in that camp, I would avoid this game at all costs. But if you're somebody who can handle really dark shit, then I'd say give this game a shot. So, the true ending, because for whatever reason, there's always a true ending to JRPGs and anime games and that kind of thing. The true ending is, at least it, as far as what I know and what I've seen from other videos and reviews and that kind of thing with this game, the true ending is, you end up with Monica, and you know it's happy ever after. Then there's another ending with Monica where, and this was the ending I got, unfortunately, but I always seem to get the unfortunate endings when it comes to JRPGs, at least so far. So one ending is you end up with Monica, happy ever after. The second ending is you end up with Monica by yourself. You guys are having a long, extensive conversation that feels like it goes on forever. And then she finally confesses to you that she loves you, she wants the best for you, she wants to be with you for the rest of her life, and she tells you that, you know, you're real to her, you know, you're real, and then she also tells you, you know, this is all a game and, you know, all a simulation inside your head. And but she becomes more and more self-aware as the game goes on, which is actually kind of scary in itself. And at the end of the day, she just wants to be with you. So there is a way to try, and there is other ways to go the other routes, but me just playing it for the first time and going through the first run, I got the Monica ending. So I will definitely have to play this again. But first impressions are everything, and this left a good first impression. So if I had to rate this game, I'm gonna give it like a 8.5 out of 10. It's really solid. If you like horror games, if you like psychological horror, I would recommend this. If you like anime and stuff like that, I also recommend this. And believe it or not, I actually have two of the side stories to do, so I think I'm going to do those after I'm done with this video. And, yeah. So, hopefully I didn't miss too much. If I missed anything, let me know down in the comments below if you've played this game. And tell me what you think about it down in the comments below. So, yeah. Now, of course, we have to pick best girl. Before we end a video like this, we have to pick best girl. Because that's one of the, like, standard, or that's one of the golden rules in anime. You always gotta pick a best girl with JRPGs and animes and shit like that. So, who would I pick as my best girl in this game? Well, considering I only have four options, you know, at least the choices are, you know, not as big. You know, it's not like we're picking from 20 different characters or 100 different characters or 1,000. We got an easy four to choose from, so that's nice. You know, for the longest time when I was playing this game, my first run, I picked Yuri, and Yuri was my girl, but you know what? After playing this and after going through it and getting the ending that I got, I'm gonna have to pick Monica. My heart and my mind have been changed, and I'm gonna have to pick Monica as my best girl. So yeah. With all that said, it's my review of Doki Doki, a literature club. Hope you guys enjoyed. Again, if you haven't played this game, I recommend it. If you have played this game, tell me all about it in the comments below.